Duckload.
He has stalkers out. He has sentries. This is probably going to be able to be well held off pretty well right here. He's getting out more speedlings, throwing down a new hatch, using his overlords. He really needs to get ventral sacks right here. If he got ventral sacks and just drop banelings over here, just rain banelings over here, oh my goodness, it would be over. Because he'd be able to take... he would have this other expansion right here, which is pretty much what he's taking advantage of, but... Steel guys, that would be amazing. He is researching Warp Gate right now, throwing down two more simulators, and he is just Zerglings over here holding him in, so he's not gonna be able to get in that expansion for a while. So it is a good thing that he got that when he went ahead and got this early expansion right here and walled off from down here, because if he wouldn't have, he'd have been held up in this base with Zerglings out here harassing him, which would have made this game an entirely different story. So.
So you see, he's just chilling on that Zelnaga tower with all his speedlings, just making sure WhiteRa doesn't make it out of his base with anything.
So Stalker stalking the perimeter. No upgrades yet. He is throwing pylons down, so he does know whether there's going to be a Nidus network.
Yeah, Nidus network going down.
I'm not exactly sure if that's why he did that, but it's a great idea. So he had to get the baneling nest to get the banelings. He is pumping out more drones and overlords. So I'm not seeing any more attack units go down. He is just keeping the speedlings for now, not upgrading them. But the stalkers are in range of this overlord right here. They're right out of range of the overlord.
This game looks promising to be a long game, a drawn out game at this point. I'm really interested to see how this ends up. This is really exciting for me at the moment, and I don't get too excited about the replays all that much, but this looks pretty interesting right here.
So we do have the Zerger coming out. Going to be sent right over here to his base. He is pooping out creep over here.
Oh,
so
I'm thinking that Observer. No, not Observer. Is it Observer that's pumping out right now?
Right there.
Okay. I was thinking it was one of those spawning...
Warp Prism.
Yeah, Warp Prism.
So right now, it looks like he's upgrading to a layer right now, and he is not getting any units right now, except for over here he's getting workers. Okay, so we're still keeping the speedlings, and it looks like WhiteRa is pumping out a Colossus now. Yes, this is exactly what he needs against Zergs. Guys, Colossus are amazing against Zergs. And it looks like he's... Oh, yeah, he's about to move out. He did take down his own pylon here, so he is about to move out and do an attack. Does he have charge slots? Oh, I do not know. I do not know. Does he have a... No, he does not have a Twilight Council. Anyway.
They got a battle going on.
Oh, yes. So he is
a very
off,
good job
walling off the banelings, but the banelings are getting in there, doing some damage on these stalkers. And oh no, WhiteRa has to get out as fast as he can back to these photon cannons. That was a...
Oh yes,
brought him back. So yeah, he did split up the speedlings right there. One speedling getting away. He doesn't try to stalk him down, but I'm not sure really how well that's going to go.
No pun intended.
Oh, it's all intended. So he is going to try to take this high yield right now. I'm not really sure how well that's going to go down, but at the same time, Dimaga is getting out more speedlings. Oh man, how annoying. When they can just run anywhere they want at any time. But... they are weak, and he does have a Colossus out. These speedlings are going to be pointless right now.
Yeah.
He's got Zealots out. Oh, man. He really needs a Twilight. He could use a Twilight Council right now. He is getting, two more Colossus. I know where this game is going fast. Getting the armor upgrade for level 1. And he'll have the weapon upgrade. This is not looking good at all for Dimaga right now. It was looking good pretty early with his banelings, but not so much anymore. WhiteRa has a substantial army.
WhiteRa just got this army out so fast.
I don't know how he just got it out so fast. Uh-oh! Bird banglings. Not going to be good for WhiteRa. Oh, he sees it with the Observer! Oh, man. How upsetting for Dimaga. Oh, man. He was about to do some damage on those guys.
That might have changed it right there.
Oh, man. That Observer just saved his butt. So he is bringing the Colossus. Oh, yes, and he's going to be able to take out any of these units. Queen going down fast. Ultralisk! Oh, I had
best
no idea Ultralisks
game.
Are coming out. And this Ultralisk is already down by his Colossus. Colossus is going to throw himself up to the high ground and be able to let the yep, Dimaga's going ahead and saying GG. Great micromanagement, great macro. WhiteRa did a great job. You can see the best thing that WhiteRa did was to build down here instead of up here. Because like I said, he would have cut himself off from any expansion because the speed lanes would have held him down the entire time.
That is a very good strategy. Wow.
So, also, he is a pro, so he knows exactly what he's doing. He did a great job of walling off early and then expanding his wall off to photon cannons. So, he had a very slow start with his units, but it worked out all in the end. So you just have to make sure you keep up with your macro and micro, especially against when you're Protoss against anybody. You have to do great micro because, like I said, if you get rushed by Marine Marauder, you have to do great micro with the sentries. If you do rushed by the Zerg, you have to do great micro because those speedlings can get in there so fast, and that's you're over as soon as they get in.
And what allowed him to do that right there was early scouting. That was a lot of probably what he based his strategy on. He went back and did a lot of good scouting and was able to get those high techs up real quick. So that was a really good game. I appreciate y'all watching. We appreciate y'all watching. Leave us a comment. Leave us feedback on how you thought we did on the commentary. And if y'all enjoy seeing the pros play, I'm sure y'all do. I don't know why you wouldn't. Our gameplay can get a little bit repetitive, but, I mean, of course, we're doing a lot better now. Subscribe for future videos. We'll have a lot more coming up in the future, of course. And give us a thumbs up if you liked it. So, appreciate it. See you guys.